So what you have to do is now you have to solve example 2 using this superposition, solve example 2, which is the bar is fixed here and fixed here, u of 0 equals 0, u of l equals 0, and it has constant load p, and here l, solve using superposition or what we call it indirect integral equation, and verify your solution, and verify your solution with comparison with previous lecture solution. Example 3, the same. What you have to do is to compute, when we have P here, concentrated load at A, and this is L minus A. You have to solve this again using indirect integral equation, like what we did in example 2. You have to solve it here, and you have to verify it. Actually, this problem we have now, we can solve it using the previous lecture in L1. We can use it using two ways. Either direct integration, relation via Dirac delta notation, or using zones. We said we can divide it into two zones, and we can solve it in L2 using superposition together with the idea of complementary solution and particular integral. The particular integral here is a solution for the concentrated load here. Okay, so what we have to do now is to solve as much as we can using one way or two way or three ways until we verify that we have all the solutions are the same. Okay, I'm ending now part one of my lecture. So what I did today is I have represented the solution of any differential equation using superposition series. So the solution of any differential equation u of x equal to sigma u asterisk of x minus xi I times the intensity of the source at xi I. This is wonderful series. This is wonderful series. Why? Because this is always known. This is a fundamental solution and it is always known. Okay? And this is the intensity of fictitious load. By the way, before I give a break, I will give a break in 2 minutes, but ask yourself, in our beam, and it is defined here at x equal 0 and at x equal L, we place the sources one time, one source here and one source here. After that, in another way, we put the source here and here, and I ask you to do it by yourself. The question is, can I put the two sources on one side? I can. Try it. Try it and see what you will get. Okay? right and see what you will get. Move the sources around the beam and see what you will get at the end of the day. Okay? At the moment, I will give 10 minutes break. I will give 10 minutes break and we'll come back to carry out the part two of the lecture. In part two of the lecture, we can have, we will reformulate the problem again using what we call it the direct integral equation, alternative way of formulating the problem.